Hi, I'm Brian Boswell with Keysight Technologies. I'm a design engineer, and I'll be describing a PV inverter test set. Using the Keysight Technologies N8937 APV photovoltaic array simulator and the PA2203 IntegraVision Power Analyzer. The device under test that we'll be talking about today is a 12 kVA transformerless 480 volt three-phase inverter. Okay? The input is normally supplied by a solar array. We'll be simulating that with the N8937 APV, which will supply is sourced by 208 volt three phase input, which then generates the DC input to the inverter. The output is connected to 480 volt three phase, and I'll be measuring the output of the inverter using channels 1, 2, and 3 on the three phases connected to neutral. And on the input, I'll be using channel 4 to measure the voltage and current of the DC input to the inverter. And these are wired into the power analyzer. So that's our configuration. I'll now talk about how it's actually wired. Our 208 three-phase input comes into our power supply, which does the three-phase AC to DC conversion. The output of the power supply then supplies the input to the inverter mounted here. The inverter output is then connected to 480 volt three-phase, which then goes out to the three-phase power of our building. So power is being transferred from the 208 through back out to the 480 volt three phase. Okay. The one thing I might note here on my wiring conventions is, because I'm using a standard breakout box here, I've defined the power as being delivered from the wall. Okay, so positive power would be coming out of the wall. Because the power flow through our test system is from the 208 to the 480, I should expect to see negative power as measured on our input group. Okay, and we'll see that once we power up. Okay, with that, I'll go ahead and get set up. For consistency, I like to store all of my setups on my USB stick and then just recall them when I want to use them. So we'll put that in and recall our setup. There's my setup. Okay, so I've now got the power analyzer configured. I've pre-configured the PV simulator, and what I've got it doing is tracking to a solar simulation curve, which we program with the short circuit current and the open circuit voltage and then the maximum power point voltage and current. So this is the output characteristic, which corresponds to the following power curve. And you'll notice what we expect the inverter to do is start at the open circuit voltage, increase power until it reaches the maximum, and that's where it's going to track to that maximum power. So once we power on the system, we'll actually see that work. So with that, let me go ahead and apply the 480 volt input to the system. Okay. So we now see I've got input voltage that we're measuring that's coming into the inverter. I haven't actually turned on the array simulator, so nothing's actually being converted yet, but we can go into the system and actually look at the voltage is that being measured. 280 volts line to neutral, which is, of course, is 480 volt three phase. So our voltage is there, and if you look at the power, very little power being developed at this point. Okay, to kick things off, what I'll do, we can see that the array simulator is in the curve mode and it's set up for 200 volts at 20 amps, which would be 12 kVA. So it's exactly the maximum power of our inverter. So we'll go ahead and start that. And if you notice, the power supply went to 750 volts, just like it's supposed to. And so we're now sitting right at this point, waiting for the inverter to actually turn on. In a few seconds here, you'll hear the inverter start to turn on, and it'll start to start converting power. So give it just a second. There we can hear the inverter starting to kick on, and if you watch the power supply, you'll actually see when it starts to sense the power and start to do some conversion. There you're starting to see some current flow. Okay, I actually like to click this over and watch the power build up. So this is the output voltage, and this is the output DC power being delivered by the N8937 APV. Okay, we're up to 5 kilowatts, excuse me. Continues, and if you look at the front of the power analyzer, you see we've now got currents being built up as well as the power waveforms being displayed. And we continue to, more and more power is being converted by the inverter from the DC out to the 480 volt. Okay? Voltage waveforms are at the top, the current waveforms are in the center, and I'm displaying the power waveforms here on the bottom. Okay. We've pretty much reached our maximum power point of 12 kVA. Okay, things are pretty stable right now. If we're looking at the the grouping here on the output power, again, the voltage is still 280 volts. I now have 13.8 amps flowing, which converts to 11.65 kilowatts. And notice the sign, negative power being driven out back onto our 480 volt grid. Okay? So the system is now fully up and running. The next thing we might want to look at is what's the efficiency of the system. If we look at our CWA analysis, one of our options here is efficiency. I've predefined a couple of different efficiencies that we'll be looking at. Efficiency one being the power being delivered from channel 4, that's the DC input to the inverter, and the output being the group A, or the output of the inverter. If you look at that setup, it's showing an input power of 11.9 kilowatts, an output power of minus 11.65, for a total efficiency of minus 97.4%. Okay? This particular inverter, the manufacturer specifies an efficiency of greater than 97%, so it appears to be doing what the manufacturer said it would do. I also set up a second efficiency set to look at, In this case, I'm looking at the input being the group A total power and the output being one of the phases of the power. So we'll see how well the power is being converted on a phase-by-phase basis. And if you look at this case, minus 11.6, minus 3.9 for an efficiency of 33.45. So you can see it's being split fairly equally between the three phases. You can look at each of the phases if you'd like by scrolling through them. And again, just about exactly 33% on each one of those. Okay? Another test that you might want to look at would be to look at the harmonics of some of the signals. In this case, I'm looking at the harmonics of one of the phase currents. In this case, phase current one, which is displayed, has a total harmonic distortion of about 4%. And each one of the harmonics of that are showed here. You can also display that as in a table format and see the various sizes of each of the harmonics there. Could look at the same thing for maybe one of the voltage channels. In that case, significantly higher THD, or significantly lower THD, higher signal integrity. The voltage is actually measuring about 1% in this case. Okay. Another type measurement you might want to be making on inverters would be the phasor diagram. In this case, we're going to look at it for group A, that being the output. The phasor diagram in this case is very close to ideal, with each one of the voltage waveforms being 120 degrees out of phase and the currents being nearly identical to 180 degrees out of phase. Okay? And we can verify that if you come back to the power quality panel and look at the power factor. You see the power factor on group A at 0.993. Okay, so very, very efficient inverter at a very very high power factor. As I was putting together this little demonstration, one of the things that I noticed about this setup that surprised me was when I looked at this current waveform, I noticed that there was a small signal on the input power, that being channel 4, signal. And I was interested because the input is actually DC, but I can see that there's a waveform on there. Well, the PA2203 has the ability to zoom in on that signal and investigate it. So one of the things that I did was, let's take a look at that current signal. The best way to do that would be to let's AC couple on it. Okay, we're now AC coupled. We'll center the waveform. We'll turn on auto ranging. And we'll expand that waveform such that we can actually look at it. We'll do the same thing with the voltage waveform. Increase the resolution on that waveform, and we'll do the same thing on the power waveform. We've now got them AC coupled, auto-ranged, and zoomed in to the point where we should be able to see some signal, and I notice that it's a high-frequency signal. I increase my sweep speed and I can now see the signal. Come over to my power analysis, switch over to channel 4. And I can see that the frequency of the current waveform is switching, has an AC signal on it at 32 kilohertz, which I suspect is actually the switching frequency of the inverter itself. So by AC coupling on the waveform, we're able to remove the DC offset, zoom in on the signal, and actually see the switching waveform. The other thing that you may notice as you're watching the waveform here is occasionally I'm seeing an increase in the power waveform, okay? So that might be a second thing we could zoom in and look for. One of the things that the PA2203A has is the ability not only to see the power waveform, but you can trigger on the power waveform. So let's change our triggering from voltage 1, which was the nice stable channel. Let's trigger on the power 4 waveform. Okay? Once we do that, we can adjust our trigger level to then see the intermittent power levels that are occurring there. And we can now, we know it's an event that's happening fairly seldom, so I decrease my sweep speed to the point where I can actually see this intermittent event and trigger on it. And what we see is occasionally there's a adjustment to the voltage waveform by triggering on this power signal. We can zoom in and see that, okay? So this is just an example of some of the measurements that you can make with the PA2203 and find information in those signals that can add insight into the design that you're trying to analyze. With that, I'm going to call the video to a conclusion, and hopefully you've enjoyed the information presented, and thank you.